Hello. I will discuss about the Poisson's ratio. It's a very important topic of the mechanics of solid. So it is represented by the sign mu, and it's a ratio of the lateral strain upon the longitudinal strain. So first of all, discuss about the strain. So if we take a small bar, a small bar is a small this kind of piece of metal or any kind of material. If we apply the force field on both the sides, then let's suppose the length of the bar is L, and after the effect of this force, the directions of this length increases to delta. So the strain is defined as the change in length upon the original length. This is the definition of the strain. So if you come in the Poisson's ratio, it is a ratio of the lateral strain upon the longitudinal strain. Longitudinal is the direction along the length is the longitudinal direction. For example, in this case, this is the longitudinal direction, and perpendicular to this direction is a lateral direction. For example, if you take the example of this board, so this is the along the length, this is a longitudinal axis, and perpendicular to this board, say in the vertical axis or perpendicular to this board, it is a lateral direction. So if you come in Poisson's ratio, it is a lateral strain upon the longitudinal strain. So this is always negative, that's why we have used the mod. For example, let's take an example of the rubber, your eraser. If you apply the force in this direction, so if you are applying the force in the longitudinal direction, and so you can observe that the length of the rubber or the eraser increases. But if you observe on the perpendicular direction, so in the this x direction, in y direction, and this perpendicular direction, you will observe that the dimensions always decreases. So if longitudinal strain increases, then lateral strain always decreases. On the other hand, if the longitudinal strain decreases, if you apply the force in this way, so this dimension reduces and this dimension increases. So if it reduces, then this increases. So it is always negative, that's why we have put a sign mod here. So the ranges of this Poisson's ratio is from 0 to 0.5. So we use a zero value in the application of the positive beverages or the scotch. In positive beverages, we don't use a cap of the bottle, we use a cork, because the cork has a Poisson's ratio of 0. This means that if any thermal stress, because of the thermal stress, because of the thermal variation, if the length increases, so there will be a no decrease or increase in dimension of this in this direction. So we can say that it has a 0 Poisson's ratio. Let's take a problem of the one dimension. If we apply the force in this direction, so because of this force, let us say the sigma stresses induces in this direction. So in the x direction, this is given by sigma by E, by the Hooke's law. And what about the sigma epsilon y? It is the strain in the y direction. This can be found by the Poisson's ratio, because we have already defined it is the ratio of lateral strain, that is epsilon y in y direction. Let us say this is y direction and this is x direction. So this is epsilon y upon epsilon x. So epsilon y will be equal to mu times of epsilon x, or it is mu times of epsilon x is equal to sigma y. So we can write sigma y. And because we have taken a mod, so this may be a negative, and this is negative, and this is minus times of mu of sigma e. Because here the direction, in this direction, the longitudinal direction, the length is increases, so in this direction it decreases. If we take a problem of two dimension, sigma y, sigma y, sigma x, sigma x.